to my wife. I still remember the day I first saw you, the smile on your face, your kind words to me and the jokes we shared. I see these vows.
Didn't know that I'd fall so hard. Then my feet left the ground. Gravity don't make no sense when you're around.
Not as a promise, but a life I would cherish and honor. As it says in the Song of Solomon, chapter 3, verse 4, I have found the one whom my soul loves. Edith, I love your patience. I love your smile.
I slip and wonder who I'd be if I never found you and you never found me. Well, I don't wanna see.
Edith is a friend to all of us. I won't speak personally, but what I can say is congratulations from your friends. We are praying for you. We love you. And we know that God, who has made this day happen, will surely, surely make it a success.
Personally, I'm very happy to have been part of this journey. I remember when Josh had first met Edith. I was with Josh that summer and he seemed quite very sad. But by the time winter was ending, Josh was the happiest person. You should have just seen him that time for you to realize how happy he was when he met Edith.
If you ever go to pieces, fall between the thunder clouds, I will put you back together. I won't let you down. I slip and wonder what I'd do if you never found me and I never found you. I don't know what I'd do.
I love your assertiveness. You're beautiful. You're truly a Proverbs 31 woman. I promise to tell you that I love you every day and also show you that I love you. I promise to listen when you don't feel hurt. I promise to continue being your hype man. I can't promise to solve all your problems, but I promise you'll not solve them alone. I love you, Edith.
Joshua is, oh my God, I call him my brother. He's the most selfless person that I know. And there's something I need to testify. Joshua is a very brilliant human being.
But Josh is a friend in the realest sense, a kind of brother from another mother. If you ever need him, he's always there and he's very selfless. He gives himself wholly to any cause that concerns his friends.
It's biblical, it's biblical.
My dear husband Joshua, glory to God that we are back where we first met.
Birds flying high.
When we met, we talked for 3 hours, but this time we are back and we are getting married. You're not asking me this time whether I'm a fresher or a musoga, but we are asking to be blessed in our marriage. Isn't that amazing? The journey with you has been amazing and beautiful. I love the way you're so caring, thoughtful, selfless, hardworking, and a pusher. When I want to do something that I'm doubting my ability to do, I tell you, because I know you make sure I'll do it.
Eden and I have been friends for a very long time, and we are sisters now. I remember the first time she told me about Josh. It was so electrifying. You can tell that she was captivated by him, his kindness, his thoughtfulness, all the gestures. Ah! No, you could tell that a day like this was set in stone and meant to happen. And we thank God that we are glad to see the union of Edith and Josh.
Here today before God, our families and friends, I vow to love you with all what I have, to respect you and treat you like a prince you are, to be a virtuous and capable wife as illustrated in Proverbs 31. I promise to be completely gentle and patient with you, holding you with love for the rest of our lives. I love you so much.